Both major parties are pledging to keep the lights on and power prices down as the election battle turns to the rising cost of living. And both leaders were campaigning in Tasmania today, with the Prime Minister committing more cash to Antarctic research.
Australia has a long-standing claim over 40% of Antarctica, which very few nations recognise.
And you can see the Australian Antarctic Territory is slightly different colour there.
Yes.
The Prime Minister has committed $804 million to the Antarctic Division for more drones, helicopters, planes and snow vehicles, useful for science, conservation and watching China and Russia, both of which have a keen interest in the ice continent's minerals and fish stocks.
We need to keep eyes in Antarctica because there are others who have different objectives to us.
Scott Morrison's eyes are firmly fixed on being re-elected.
Our plan is working. How do I know that? Because Australians are working.
Today, both he and Anthony Albanese were chasing marginal seats in Tasmania.
Labor is ready for government.
And with voters' wages stretched by the rising cost of living, both leaders are pledging to keep a lid on power prices.
We do need reliable, secure power, and we need it to be the cheapest possible.
We understand the need for reliable and affordable energy, not just reducing emissions.
The energy system's in the midst of a revolution with the exit of coal and the rise of weather-dependent wind and solar. It's a delicate dance, and the pace of change may quicken in the wake of a surprise bid for the nation's biggest power producer, AGL.
We're well aware of our plan and what it will cost to execute.
AGL rejected the first bid, but the game isn't over, and the bidders, tech billionaire Michael Cannon-Brookes and Canada's Brookfield Asset Management, say the plan is to accelerate the closure of the company's coal plants.
And we're planning to replace it with renewables and storage and a whole lot of smart technologies to bring people's bills down.
The Treasurer says there are high risks in a rapid exit from coal.
Australia needs to maintain the stability of our grid and the affordability of power.
And the government might intervene to stop the deal. Chris Yulman, Nine News.